Well, Fucus, welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are good. I'm gonna see what wants to come out. I'm a high priestess on the back of the deck. First card out, eight of pentacles. The magician. You're mastering something right now. It feels like having to work twice as hard to find an effortless way of doing something. That thing of a lot of companies won't hire the smartest person, but the person that finds the easiest way to do something. Time is money. It feels like you've learned how to create something, but you've learned how to keep something in your reality. You could have gone through a period of attracting something and losing it, or feeling like something was just in your grasp and it not coming in. There's a shift taking place here. Something's coming into fruition. This isn't a time to doubt your magic. This is a time to get real resourceful. It's not a case of one or the other. It's not a case maybe of this road or that, or saying yes to this opportunity and no to the other. Maybe it's a case of saying yes to all things. If they align with you, you may be in some case like overthinking something, whether like what way to go. Don't limit yourself in any way right now. It feels like you've created lots of different avenues, but there's opportunities to do more things, to do more than one thing at once. The Star, the Nine of Cups, this is a dream come true. You've had to level up in order to create this lifestyle in whatever way that is. Face those parts of yourself that make you feel uncomfortable. It feels like this has been something you've been working at for a long time. One more. Yeah, Eight of Swords, Eight of Cups is giving karmic situations. Eight. This is over now. Something you once experienced is like it's left your being. It feels like transcending something. This isn't by accident. You've made a big commitment to free yourself from something that was holding you back. Feels like a release of trauma, the Hermit, Virgo energy. It feels like waking up from a nightmare and not being able to tell yourself that it was just a dream. You could have gone through a lot unconsciously. You could have just gone through so many different kind of situations that you weren't able to catch your breath in between. It feels like suddenly things have come to a standstill. You've been forced to process certain things, to go to the depth of certain things. Maybe going back into certain events, going into the pain, into the wound of things, the Moon. You're creating your own blessings, you're creating a huge change. Whatever you're doing, it feels like you could be doubting if something's working. Oh yeah, it's working. The Star. The Lovers. All right. The Chariot. Ace of Wands, it's go time. Something that liberates you, something that feels good. Follow your passion, follow your heart. Follow the feeling, the emotion. It's time to really shine your light, to show up. It's like something's over now. Don't get stuck in the healing trap. It's like you face something head on. Make sure you're not waiting for something to be perfect or waiting for some kind of sign that something's over. It's like the fact that these opportunities are coming in, the fact that you're able to be creating what you're creating right now is the sign that it's over, that there's a new beginning here. It may be time just to take a rest. This has been coming up, time to rest. Yeah, what's this? What is this? Yeah, it feels sore. It feels sore. Like a fear of repeating the past. Actually having to watch what's happened, see what's happened. It could be difficult to process these feelings. It could be very uncomfortable feelings coming up. Things from the past, maybe shame, guilt, regret, disappointment, hurt. It feels like keeping the lid on something for so long, but it's as you've slowed down, things are bubbling over. There's a way of looking at things. It's like what you went through or the things you've faced. Seeing yourself as a victim to those things, or having compassion for yourself for being the victim of those things, but then choosing to see the lesson, choosing to see how these things have shaped you, where this has got you to, the High Priestess, the Fool. Would you have even known what you wanted if you hadn't seen or experienced certain things? There's something about being mindful of those around you. As much as it might be easier, or it might seem like people are living in an easier way around you, it feels like they're not living in a way that is you. That even if you lived in, did something in an easier way, or you didn't have certain things that you had to face, there'd be some dissatisfaction because something you've gone through has shown you to yourself. It's opening this new path. It's shown you your gifts. It's that visionary energy, the High Priestess, the Hierophant. It feels like you know you're mastering your emotions right now. This is something that you're consciously working on. I'm hearing DMX give me a sign. It's like you're about to get this sign. You could be waiting on communication for something, feeling at a loss. Feel that some kind of abandonment feeling. This could be something you're working through. It feels like there's something coming in here, something for the long term. This informs in the form of a relationship. It's a dreamy energy. It's a wise energy. Some of you, there's someone coming back from the past. For those of you, this is regarding love. There's someone coming back from the past and someone new coming in. And it's almost like a test for you to choose what aligns with your dreams. Have you learned your lesson? Do you know what's for you? Do you know what is really right for you? What is driving your decision making when it comes to choosing a partner or choosing a... whether it's business, love, this is coming through for some of you, like a new love coming in and an ex coming back, someone that broke your heart in the past. Somebody could be coming in to propose. It's like, be mindful of being flattered. You've seen the light. Something's become conscious. Ace of Pentacles. Some of you, it's like, will you turn down what's already burnt you with the faith that something's better's coming in? Or is impatience going to cause you to settle? It feels like you might ponder on the idea, but in the moment you make the decision, you'd never go back to something, even if you played with the idea. Some of you have got an agreement. Some of you have got like an agreement spiritually. It's like you're going to make the right decision for you either way, for us all, the Wheel of Fortune, the Hermit, the Sun. It's like something comes over you in the moment. Spirit comes through you in the moment. Your higher self wakes up in the moment. Ace of Cups. It's like, it's almost funny that you fear that you can't trust yourself because of how much it's coming through here with clarity, that there's no way you're going to make the decision that puts you in some kind of compromise or known compromise. Feels like you could be worried or feeling that you need to avoid someone or avoid a situation, because what if you can't resist? What if you can't trust yourself? Give yourself some credit. Realize how far you've come. Whether this is to do with business or love, again, like I said, feels like love, but it's a general reading. Four of Swords, the Star. All work and no play, being weighed down by too many responsibilities. Ask for help from others. 111. It's like your angels are waiting to be called on. Have you asked for help? As well as asking whoever for help, it's like, have you asked for help? It's like when you're honouring that ancestral wisdom, when you're honouring your guides, when you're connecting to yourself, connecting to your guides, when you're asking for help, when you're willing and open to the guidance, things are beautiful. When we get in that place of frustration, maybe start casting out our ancestors, things go quickly left. It's like, you choose how you want things to go. Are you open? Are you moving from that heart space? Happy news about your career, promotions or scholarships, well thought out plans that go perfectly, needing a little push to get going. Studious, responsible, cheerful and mischievous. Be assertive when it comes to what you know is right. Everything going your way. A good person or company to work for. Compassionate, accomplished, charismatic and gifted. 444. A Fucus. It's time to take action. Be fearless and happily pursue your most treasured dreams, amazing career opportunities. See what Alice is saying. You've got a mad tea party, number 16. Haven't pulled this one before. Stop with the bunny's little glasses. Love. In the story right after encountering the Cheshire Puss, Alice stumbled upon a house in front of which there was a table set for tea time. Three characters were sitting there, the March Hare, the Mad Hatter, and a Dormouse. It didn't take long for Alice to understand that they were all irremediably insane, and that this triple encounter would have no rhyme or reason whatsoever, meaning things are really getting weirder and weirder, and it is all going too fast, leaving you feeling like a stranger in a foreign land. Adapt and muddle through, and keep your nerves steady the whole time, for this mess is not meant to last for too long. Just pretend to be attending some entertaining and yet goofy show, before eventually moving on to more serious and interesting matters. Key question, are you able to discern when things stop making sense and when it may be time for you to leave the room? Interesting, something similar come up with Cappy's reading. A couple of these cards that come out are similar. Maybe check that if you feel called to. Are you feeling like a stranger in a foreign land? Isn't it interesting how we all live on this same planet and would feel like a stranger on a certain part of the planet just because it has a different man-made name? Planet Earth is home, guys. The spider, opportunity right on the outskirts of your web. And number 36, the lizard, dream time. Ooh, jaguar, impeccability, and 26, squirrel. Don't chuck your integrity on the floor, my G. 202. There's something here about the spider, that dark feminine energy, that unhealthy dark feminine energy, because dark feminine energy isn't unhealthy, but that unhealthy dark feminine energy where the widow will eat her mate. You could be getting mad about something or dreaming about something or some kind of... What's driving your want to do things? Don't be distracted. It feels like being tempted by somebody that you know is not good for you. You could be dreaming about this person, 36, the lizard. That you know you're meant to be focusing and preparing for the future, but there's some pull back to an old version of yourself or wanting to experience something or just wanting to rebel or resist or having enough of something, some kind of protest. Don't cut your nose off to spite your face. Don't rain on your own parade here. Patience, don't chuck your integrity on the floor. On one, one. Not guided to read the book right now, but guided to keep going with these. So what else is going on? Building the new. There's an opportunity to build something new. It could be something so obvious right in front of you. Something that you don't even need. I'm seeing someone sitting with their head down in despair, don't know what to do. And it's like they've already got the answer right in front of them. Maybe it's on an email. Maybe it's some advert you've seen. Maybe it's something you've already created and forgot about. Maybe it's something that just needs tweaking. Maybe something's staring you right in the face. Don't be distracted by some kind of... Hummingbird, 44, joy. Do what sparks joy. What energy are you putting into your creations? It feels like coming out of some kind of lower place. Channel that energy elsewhere. Learn how to balance something out. Sexual energy is the energy of creation. It's sacred. Instead of kind of burning that fuel on some kind of short-term satisfaction that leads to maybe regret or frustration or irritation, to use that fuel to create something beautiful. Make sure you're actually doing what you want to do and not just letting off steam and being blind to the consequences of that. It's time to make a sacrifice, whether that's some kind of behavior, something you're doing. It's time to transform. Butterfly. The Queen of Hearts, number 20. Again, I haven't pulled this one before. 23, 23. In the story, the Queen of Hearts was Wonderland's monarch, quick-tempered. This book's got so many words in it that I just have never seen. I-R-A-S-C-I-B-L-E. Irascible? Irascible? Anyone know about this? Shout me. I'm going to just start again and remove that word. The Queen of Hearts was Wonderland's monarch, quick-tempered. There was nothing she loved more than decreeing death sentences, usually unwarranted. Her favourite words were off with their heads. She also liked to play croquet, but by some twisted and complicated rules, but gave her plenty of room to order executions on the spot. Later on in the story, Alice discovered that the Queen's mantra was sentence before verdict. The meaning. Well, 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 seems like someone is about to lose their temper, aren't they? And it is not such a good thing because right now your emotions are not guides you should blindly trust or follow. Let this whirlwind of intense feelings calm down before doing anything. You would only regret having acted too hastily and too emotionally. Key question, do you usually act on emotion or do you take the time to calm down before you act or speak? So just bringing awareness, pausing before you react, keeping your power in situations. Being guided to check the door in the tower, number 17. Fed up with the endless nonsense, Alice left the March Hare and the Mad Hatter and the Dormouse to their party. As she walked through the forest, she noticed that one of the trees had a door that seemed to lead right into it. This magic portal opened onto a fabulous garden with bright flower beds, trees, roses, and a beautiful fountain. All belonging to the Queen of Hearts. Meaning, you're standing in front of a new door that leads to a new chapter in your life. You may wonder if this is the right path for you. Well, it is. Surely the adventures you are going to live will be hectic and eventful, so get ready and get strong. But this fantastic journey will help you grow and become even more assertive. Key question, what portal are you getting through? And what new landscape does it open for you? Page number 31. Number 37, Anil. He is well known for his talents and for his enthusiastic and helpful astral messages. He is sometimes satirical and has crazy and revolutionary ideas, but his achievements are meaningful. He only accepts work offers or social situations if they do not go against his spiritual ideals. His firm self-control stops him from giving in to easy temptation. Planet Jupiter, reasons for invoking, to work towards resolving difficult situations, to encourage harmony between different people, to reveal the secrets of nature to us, for inspiration in meditation, to help us express ourselves more easily. Page number 31. I'm sure your Alice was page number 31 as well. 31, 31, maybe check that out. The Cow. A new beginning or even a new life may be blooming. And the new moon. The time is ripe for seeking new opportunities. King of Swords. Hello. Someone's coming in. They're coming in cutthroat. They're coming in blunt. They're coming in like, hello, I'm here. It's, it could make you feel small. Or it's like feeling a little intimidated by this person. But I feel like this is going to quickly shift. This is because of something that you felt in the past. This isn't because this is how this person's trying to make you feel. It feels like they're just very... Yeah. It feels like it's an opportunity for you to come out of yourself, get into your heart, to let your guard down, to be vulnerable, to open up. Because some of you, it's like pretending that you don't know or you don't realise or you don't want to see it or... telling yourself why you don't have time for this, but this is something you've asked for. It feels like this is coming from fear of rejection, fear of being hurt, fear of heartbreak. Yeah, fear of feeling vulnerable. Maybe you've only had a certain kind of relationship. It feels like not knowing how to act in. Like maybe you've always had serious relationships and now you're going to start dating. Or maybe you've only ever dated and now you're jumping into something more serious. It's like something contrasting. The way this comes in isn't how you usually do things. I feel like this could make you feel vulnerable, like you don't know what to do. There's not a way of doing. It's like get rid of the idea that there's a right way of doing something. Just be yourself. Follow your passion. Follow how you feel. This is something you've asked for. This is something you... It's going to make you very happy. Ask yourself how a certain way of thinking, how that's benefiting you. Is it actually benefiting you to be closed off or to expect the worst? Because it's like actually intentionally choosing to look for something different, to change the narrative, to open yourself up. Like it's not going to happen by accident. It feels like you're being asked to open up to this. This is something that's been happening. But you could still be a little bit, yeah, you're holding on, like wanting to hold on to yourself. Or it's like scared of commitment, the sun, the devil. Ah. It's like not wanting to face yourself. It's like by having, if you're going to have to open up to somebody in a relationship or this person coming in, it's going to force you to face yourself in ways that you know you're about to be facing yourself. You could feel this coming in. You could know exactly what's going on here. 3333, very intuitive. It's like, no, you'd rather not. Realizing that there's more than one side to things, like it's not all sunshine and rainbows, but it's like focus on the sunshine and rainbows. Because like the clouds and the storms are just can be just as beautiful. It's just your perspective. Like there's going to be ups and downs. There's something coming in. This is for the long term. It's like having to let go. That thing of like when you jump on a roller coaster, you can't get halfway through and be like, excuse me, can I get off? It's like once you're on, you're on. It's like you either choose to jump on or you choose to not go on. Like you either experience the ride fully or you don't. Stop trying to control certain elements of things because it's actually pushing things away. It could delay communication coming in. Yeah, it's like, don't delay your own dreams, don't delay your own fulfillment because of some kind of ego or anxiety or fear. Dinosaurs, they're all. Right, tell me about who this is. Oh, it's a really lovely energy. It feels like this person's coming in at a time when you could really do with it. It's like you both show up in each other's lives at the perfect time. You could be meeting this person, like bumping into this person physically. There's an understanding here because it's like going through similar situations. You've both had to heal heartbreak. You've both mastered emotion. This person's at a level where you're at. It feels like you're going to balance each other out, be able to celebrate each other. The Lovers, yeah. Eight of Wands. Two of Pentacles. King of Cups, the Star. Awakening number 12. Change the way you're looking at the situation. Embrace your uniqueness. A temporary pause in the action. I'm going to leave it there, guys. If this did resonate, like, share, and subscribe. I'll catch you soon. Send it somewhere.